Alright, so I think I'm live in two different groups now. So I have Witches and Heathens of CNY, and I have VIP Cauldron Parlor. I wasn't expecting to go live in Witches and Heathens, and usually if I do a live video in there, I do it later so I don't mess with Sunday school session. But I am Sunday school session tonight, so here we go. We are doing the Pomegranate Womb for Fertility Spell, and this actually comes out of Liber Khthonia, which is written by Jeff Cullen, my brother. So this will be a demonstration on how to do that working, and it's very exciting. Of course, I have ingredients all over my book already. So I am going to explain what I have going on. I'm going to go through the steps. Now, this is especially to help anyone that has the book and is interested in doing the spell for themselves. Hello, yes, I see Jeff. Yes, I see comments. Perfect. Okay, so I tried to be as prepared as possible, but we all know things can go wrong. So to start, you need a pomegranate. And this is hollowed out like a pumpkin. And yes, we are saving the top. And we will be filling it with all the fun stuff that we have. There's a few different things going on. I did have to prepare for this last week because there's certain things that have to be made at certain times. Now, again, I'm going to give page numbers to the recipes of some of the things that we have to use in here so you can refer to the recipes in the book. Hopefully you have the book. Hello. Hello. I can't read too well. I see a little bit. I see a little bit. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are taking the pomegranate. We're hollowing the pomegranate out. And then we take the two people. Oh, you know what? Let me go through the ingredients first. Okay. One thing at a time. Ingredients. So you have to make an herbal mixture. I'm sorry about this light. It's very bright. There's nothing I can do about it. You're here to listen to me anyway. So we make an herbal mixture of the following things: red rose, dried, patchouli, nettle, black snake root, fenugreek, bee pollen, red clover, red raspberry, and damiana. This will be incorporated into the pomegranate. We will also be using Three Goddesses Love Drawing Oil. Now, there is the recipe on page 229 is the recipe for the Three Goddesses Love Drawing Oil, which we will be using. And you also have to make a red unguent. So this is, whenever someone says unguent, it's always pretty much the base is like Crisco or lard of some sort to make this paste. It's a wonderful tool. There is red, white, and black unguent, which there are the ingredients. The recipe for that is also in the book. If you refer to page 244, you will find the recipe for the red unguent. Now again, it has to be made at a specific time, so that's when you should do it. You should do it on a Friday. So there's that, and I'm not going to go through the ingredients for those because this is technically for the people that have the book. And if you need the recipe, I guess shoot Jeff a message. I feel like you should just get the book instead so you have the recipes and all that. But nonetheless, we are demonstrating this spell. So those are the two pages to refer to when I'm talking about the red unguent and the Three Goddesses love drawing oil. Okay, so first we are starting with, we're going to start with the name papers. So you have to take the couple and you're printing a picture of them. What does it say? Ooh, so beautiful. Yes, it is beautiful. You have to make it beautiful. So I have a cotton pan up here. I have some roses. I have some offerings and stuff. You know, it is a lovely altar setup. So the first step is taking the couple. You make a name paper out of them. So by doing that, you put their name and date of birth, any identifying information on the back, and then what they're going for in a ring circle formation. And then what you're doing is you're putting them face to face. Okay? And then we are tying white string around them. The proud parents to be. And then we are coating this with the red unguent. It's fun to say, right? And then once this is bound, we are going to cram it in the bottom of the pomegranate. So here's my beautiful red unguent. See, it's like a paste. Wonderful. It's like thick magic. So we're coating the couple, binding them with this love drawing recipe. And I'm gonna actually put it in there and then coat the other side of it. So I did get all the seeds out, most of them, well, not all of them, but you know, try your best. You should typically have gloves on. But, you know. The couple is now inside the pomegranate. Okay. And then we are going to make a mixture. So I'm going to make this mixture. We are going to use it now, put a little bit more fun stuff, and then use more of the mixture. So I'm going to make it into one big thing, and then we'll split it up that way. So, and I did read this off already. So it's the red rose, the patchouli, the nettle, the black snake root, the fenugreek, bee pollen, red clover, red raspberry, and damiana. So I'm just going to go ahead and add all of these things. And remember, you're filling up the pomegranate, so a decent amount. This is a few ingredients all in one. And again, if anyone has any questions, if I can't read them, I will get back to them. I promise. Hi. Welcome. Hey. Now, one thing I am going to add just a little bit of is some protector grave moss. And, you know, of course you can, you know, if certain things mean certain things to you, if you want to incorporate them into it, feel free. You know, we're all about giving the bones and giving our style. So this is Jeff's style and, you know, it's from his book. But you can always incorporate your practice in as well, which is a wonderful thing. Just shake it up a little bit. Get it nice and mixed up. Shake, 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 you know. Okay, so we are going to add some of this herbal mixture. And then we're going to add something to do with a frog. So I do have frog bones. So you can add some sort of material from the frog, whether it be the bones, a dried frog, a part of the frog, or you can even use a small figurine of a frog. So that's what you're doing. Yes, exactly. Exactly, Jeff. Alright, so I'm going to use some frog bones. I'm going to use some little guys. Always, these little guys remind me of Operation. When you're playing the game Operation. So I'm going to go ahead and put three in there. But I didn't put the herbal mixture in yet, so I'm just going to take them out. And put them right there. So we're putting the herbal mix in. And I'm just going to do like half. I made a lot, I guess. That just means it's going to be full of magic. Ooh. Okay, and then the bones. And then I also have one of the ingredients is graveyard dirt from an infant. So that is what this is. And that goes on after the frog bones. Okay, and next we're going to make a potion. Okay, so this is where the three goddesses love drawing oil comes in. Let me grab a paper towel. So I can get all this stuff off my... Okay, let me see. Okay. I can't read any messages right now, just so everybody knows. Okay. All right, so we put the dirt on, so now we're going to make the fun little potion, which is raw honey, condensed milk, olive oil, a raw egg, and three goddesses love drawing oil. And that's going to be poured into the pomegranate. So I already have the oil already made. This is the three goddesses love drawing oil. And then I have the lovely mixture of the condensed milk and all that. So we're gonna mix that into a cup. This is gonna be too much probably. Pouring this in, and we will be saying some things. Just the heater, don't worry. And I will not be saying the names of the people out loud. I will be saying it in my head, obviously to protect the privacy of the people. So I put more of the herbal mixture on there before I pour this in and say the things. I don't know. Okay. Mistress Hecate, nurse to the young, aiding in childbirth, all nurturing, approach the bed of name and who wish to have a child. May this potion be as the name of the father, potent semen, and may this pomegranate be as name of mother, life-giving womb. They are joined within the crucible of life by Pan, his nymphs, who increase, so shall they make the family of increase. And they say the names there. As these herbs carry the fertility of Gaia, so too shall the semen and womb of parents' names be fertile. And then we place the top of the pomegranate back on. It's gonna gonna overflow a little bit. And then we're wrapping it with thread, red thread. It worked. This helps. Okay. So I'm using red ribbon. If it overflows, it's okay. Just have something underneath it to catch it so you're not messing with your cloths. Cloth. Okay. Sorry guys. It's hard because there's oil all over my hands. Now it's wrapped up like a little present. One more paper towel I need. Okay. It looks so beautiful. Okay. So now I'm going to seal it with wax. Typically, it is red wax. Okay. You are ensouled by Hecate, nourished by Hera. You are given life by Demeter and fertilized by the seed of Pan. By the will of the gods, in 9 months' time, a child will be born too. Insert names. Now after that, that makes me happy. After that, you burn a red candle and you do this for 9 days for the couple. And then after the 9 days, you bury the pomegranate in a beautiful, flourishing, fertile garden. You can bury it in a playground or at a mother's grave. So that is it. So I'm gonna go ahead and light the candle, my beautiful red candle. And that's pretty much it. I mean, you could get a 7-day candle and burn it for the 7 days and then just get regular candles for the rest of the time. However you want to interpret that, 9 days, red candle burnt for them. Look at this, this is so beautiful. I will bring it over to, now this cup has nothing to do underneath it other than simply just to hold it. So this is it, this is the pomegranate womb fertility spell. So I'm going to show my first camera how beautiful it is in the Witches and Heathens of CNY. And then, oh, you can kind of see it. Cool, huh? So that is the spell. And again, this comes directly from Liber Khthonia, which again is written by Jeff Cullen. And it is a contemporary witchcraft and devotional tradition of Hecate. It has so much information in here. It's such a knowledgeable book. It's a great thing to have. So, there it is. That is it. That concludes this Sunday school session and this Self-Love Sunday live that I have going on. It's the first time I ever did two different things in one, but it worked, and I hope this helps people. I know a lot of people, you know, are trying to conceive, and, you know, fertility magic is a thing, and it's definitely something that you all should look into. So here's one amazing spell that you can do in case you want to do that. So thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. If you end up doing this spell, go ahead and tag Jeff, tag the book, use the hashtag of the book, whatever. Share it. And I hope you enjoyed this. And I hope you all have a wonderful night. And good night. Now I have to figure out how to end it all over the place. But I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you, my pants are from Walmart. Okay, so I will see you all later. Bye! Nope, that didn't finish. Ah. Open my messages. Bye, guys!